We get each other and you make me a better person. I wouldn't say I was selfish before I met you. But I certainly put myself first a bit. But you and Oscar have completely changed that. You make me the happiest I've ever been, and I can't wait for the next chapter of our life together. I love you.
Crinkles by your eyes when you smile, you've never loved your stomach or your thighs. The dimples in your back at the bottom of your spine, but I'll love them endlessly.
I won't let these little. I know it's the main reason you're all here. It's a very special day. Today is my man Oscar's 6th birthday. And my beautiful wife turns 29 again.
Yay!
I'm in love with you.
I'm so excited to see you at the top of those stairs and for you to take my breath away yet again. We've talked about this day so much and I cannot tell you how happy I am that you are going to be Mrs. Spinks.
The reason that you talk in your sleep, and all those conversations are the secrets that I keep, though it makes.
Lois, I don't need to say how lovely you are because you're always lovely. But today, of all days, you look absolutely stunning. And I know that you will do your absolute best to be a loyal and kind and loving wife to Paul.
But you're perfect to me. I won't let these little things slip out of my mind.
We've followed each other around for 20 years now, from school to uni to our working lives. He's been my partner in centre mid for many years, and there's nobody I'd rather watch play a Hollywood ball, mate. He was my best man just a couple of years ago, and it's a privilege to return a favour today.
All these little things, you'll never love yourself half as much as I love you.
Sarah and Tony, how lucky are we to have such great in-laws, you know, and not only do we get on, which is great, but we'd like to count you as friends. Your generosity of spirit knows no bounds, and you must be so proud of Paul today. And also, we not only are proud of you, but what a good-looking son-in-law I've got.
Dancing on the hood in the middle of the woods of an old Mustang, where we sang songs with all our childhood friends.
I know no six-year-old wants to share their birthday, but what a party you're having. But I want to say to you, you're a very lucky boy. You've got an amazing mummy and daddy who will do anything for you. But on top of that, I want you to know I'll always do anything for you, whatever you need. You've changed my life for the better, and I love you, mate.
Fast forward to 18, we are more than lovers. Yeah, we are all we need when we're holding each other. I'm taken back to 2000.
Paul, I'd like to welcome you into our family. And it's quite a tribe, and you've met most of them, I do feel. And I think also, you will also be a kind, loving and trustworthy husband to Lois.
Jane and David, thank you so much for being so welcoming, fun to be around. You've made me feel like part of the family from day one, and I truly appreciate that. Jane, you should be so proud. You've raised such a strong-minded, smart, funny, talented, attractive daughter. But that's enough about Sophie, it's not over.
Where we sang songs with all our childhood friends. Oh, now, oops, I got 99 promise singing bye, bye, bye. Hold up, if you wanna go and take a ride with me, better hit me, baby, one more time.
Can I ask you all please to be upstanding and raise a glass to my beautiful wife, Lois? To Lois.
On the day we fell in love, love, love.
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. I'm not one of those who can easily hide.
On behalf of my wife and I, thank you so much for coming today to all of you. We really appreciate it. It means the world.
A big house where we both could live. If I was a sculptor.
Lois, you look absolutely stunning. And I can't believe I'm lucky enough to stand here and call you my wife.
It's potions in the traveling show. No, it's not much, but it's the best I can do.
Bridesmaids, Cherie, Kerry, Gemma, Sophie, thank you all so much for being such a huge part of today. Thanks for being great friends to Lois.
And you can tell everybody this is your song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done.
Shortly after we moved in together, we were thrown into lockdown. Neither of us knew how we'd handle that, being around each other 24/7, working in the same room for over a year. But somehow the closest we came to arguing and the most stressful moment was when you tried to cut my hair. And even after that, I still proposed. And you made me the happiest man in the world by saying yes.
I sat on the roof. Top the moss. Well, a few of the verses, well, they've got me quite cross. But the sun's been quite kind.
You're an amazing mum and a pretty cool one at times too. I'm sure next year you'll get your chance to win the mum's race at Oscar Sports Day. We had days of sulking this year when it got cancelled.
I'll bring you flowers in the pouring rain. Living without you is driving me insane. I'll bring you flowers, I'll make your day. The tears you cry, I will dry them all the way.
I call upon these persons here present to witness that I, Paul Michael Spinks, do take thee, Lois Victoria Louise Hudson, to be my lawful wedded wife. I promise to care for you with love, friendship and patience. I promise to support and comfort you, respect and cherish you, and be faithful always. These promises I make to you for the rest of my life.
Can't you see? I will give it to you unselfishly, because I need you so.
I call upon these persons here present to witness that I, Lois Victoria Louise Hudson, do take thee, Paul Michael Spinks, to be my lawful wedded husband. I promise to care for you with love, friendship and patience. I promise to support and comfort you, respect and to cherish you, and be faithful always. These promises I make to you for the rest of my life.
And all those flowers, they would wilt in the rain, and they will cause me misery and pain. Because I need you so.
And let's welcome Mr. and Mrs. Spinks as they make their first steps in married life.
Yeah. I'll bring you flowers in the pouring rain. Living without you is driving me insane. Comfort. We have traveled land and sea.
see. But as long as you are with me.
A lot of people have asked me if I'm nervous today, and the truth is I am nervous. The only consolation is if there's one person in the room that's as nervous and as queasy as I'm right now, it'll be the person that's just agreed to spend the rest of their life with Paul.
As long as I am with you, my heart continues to be. With every step we take, Kyoto to the bay, strolling so casually.
Pinksy, my best man. The biggest idiot I know. You've been my centre mid partner for so many years. I've grown up with you by my side, and I couldn't have today any different. Before I was with Lois, I wasn't at my happiest, and there wasn't a week went by where you didn't check in and check I was all right, and I'll never forget that. You truly are a top mate.
Our first trip away of many. We all finished uni. Most of us went to Canterbury together, mainly because we were too afraid to make any new friends. Paul did very well for himself, getting a first in business and a good job in the city after. As many of you know, Paul now works as head of risk at Nexus, which is ironic because if there's one risk everyone should be aware of, it's a well-renowned Paul Spinks head loss. Mum and Dad, Sarah and Tony, where do I start? Thank you for giving Gary and I the best start in life. Dad, you worked so hard to give us a great life. Mum, you were literally still doing everything for me this morning. But I do find myself still at another wedding that you've managed to wangle an invite to. But seriously, Mum, you're one in a billion, the best, and I'm so proud to be your son. Lois Spinks, you look gorgeous today, and happy birthday again. Unfortunately, I'm sure you've realised by now, it's too late for just a simple birthday party. You've inherited yourself another kid, just one that won't ever grow up and needs more mummying and potty training than Oscar. It's been great getting to know you better over the last couple of years, and you fit into the group so easily. Most importantly, we've also evolved from sucking the mud and now evolved to the cereal box game, which has been very well received by the lads. First time Paul told me about Lois was in a kebab shop in Blackheath after a heavy session, kind of place where all serious bloke conversations happen. And Paul was very, very worried that he wasn't mature enough or responsible enough to be a stepdad, looking for some reassurance. If I'm honest, I was more petrified than Paul, but I tried my best and tried to make him think that it was all going to be all right. I always hate the question of what do you do for work, because credit insurance is really boring. But we're both fortunate enough to have met so many great friends through our work, many of whom are in the room today. But I honestly never thought that credit insurance would lead me to the love of my life. Balance sheets.
If you'd all like to raise your glasses to the bride and groom. Bride and groom.